Hey, this is Cecil Peanut Daniels here in Boulder, Colorado, outside the Fox Theater, and I just walking down the street and ran into a couple of good friends of mine, and I'd like for you to meet them. My dear friends from Stockholm Syndrome, Mr. Dave Schools, and Mr. Jerry Joseph. How you guys doing? You out here to do some music, I assume, huh?
Well, we're going to put on a show here at the fabulous Fox Theater here in Boulder tonight. And it's part of a long weekend of lots of music for all of us.
That's great. You know, once I had saw where you guys kind of like started your tour in Germany, and I was wondering, like they're ready for you here, they're ready for you over there?
Well, it was funny because we started, first Dave and I did a tour as a duo. That's kind of where the whole thing came from, really. It was this duo tour, and we needed a name, and I can't even remember how we got the name, but those were the posters that were in Europe, and then we started the Stockholm thing. Well, we haven't been back as Stockholm.
Well, we had to, we realized something that I had never realized before, is they have a lot of laws in Europe about how loud you can play. I mean, they're literally laws, just, and they take them as seriously as a town like Boulder takes the no smoking law. You know, like places in Germany take this, you can't go louder than this law, and we're kind of a loud band, so we had, but we had a German sound man who was at wit's end every single day. You know, he went from basically asking us to turn down, to telling us to turn down, to begging us to turn down, to saying, I'm not going to ever work with you again if you don't turn down, and you can run your own sound from the stage, for all I care.
Did you guys ever have any problems with authorities or anything coming to shut you down for your volume?
No, just the sound man. He had the problems.
Great. You have any plans for a new album, anything to be coming out?
We actually, Jerry and I got together, I guess about a year ago, and spent a couple of days working on some song ideas and coming up with songs, and then we convened in a studio in Cotati, California, a chicken coop of a studio, and spent about 2 weeks with John Keane recording songs and the band, Danny Lewis and Wally Ingram and Eric McFadden. And so it's finished, and hopefully you'll be hearing it in, you know, by 2010.
Ooh. Now, what are your plans after Boulder?
Well, we just finished this record and just got done. And so now I think we're going to see if anyone cares. And if that happens, then one of the things with this record is that we're going to try to do dates on some sort of regular basis.
This project, Stockholm Syndrome, it's important to all of us because it's more than a side project. You know, it started off as something that Jerry and I needed to do together and found out that we could write songs together. And then as the band got put together, you know, it grew into almost a family. You know, I hate to use that word, but it's true. And you know, there's more collaboration and more being as a family together. So this record it's really different than the first record, just for the simple philosophical fact that it sounds like a band and not a side project.
Right.
And that was important to us.
So when is it due to be released, you think?
We're working on that. Brian Schwartz is working on that. You know, like Jerry said, we just finished it. It's mastered to the point of where I'm happy with the sound of it.
Is there a name for it, Kick? If I may ask, have you come up with a name for that?
It's tentatively titled Apollo.
Oh, cool.
It has nothing to do with NASA.
Okay.
But, you know, it's a process of seeing if there's label interest. And being able to set it up properly, and then when it's set up properly, being able to line all the different guys up to get out there and support it and play the music that's on it. So that's sort of just, it puts it probably into 2010, which is never what we like, but I think that the music, we'll have written a whole nother album worth of songs by then, so.